Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah.
Brothers and sisters, and we are still reciting شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan is the month that the Quran was revealed in it. It has guidance for humanity and clear proof within its guidance. And a powerful and an ultimate separation between falsehood and truth. Brothers and sisters, to renew our intention every day in Ramadan, to renew our commitment to this deed, to renew our belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these beautiful days of Ramadan, ayyama ma'budat. They are countable days, and we are already on the second half of Ramadan. 11 days are already gone from Ramadan. You ask yourself, yourself, we ask ourselves, what have we achieved so far? What have we done different from last Ramadan? Are we really doing more and better than the last Ramadan? Am I going to continue in the same pace or better in the rest of Ramadan? Where are we with the Quran? Where are we with the Qiyam? Where are we with the Sadaqat? Where are we with the unity of the Muslim Ummah? Where are we with changing our attitude? Where are we with changing our mind? Where are we with changing the community? Where are we in all of these aspects? This is about Ramadan. That every time you reach Ramadan, it's a new thing for Muslims to renew their introduction to Islam, to renew themselves to the Quran. Every day you open Al-Fatiha and you recite Al-Fatiha, you find there is something new you learn about Al-Fatiha. Every time you recite, every year you recite Al-Baqarah, you find something in you you learn from Al-Baqarah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is the month of Quran, not the month of Siyam. He didn't say Shahru Ramadan, Shahru Siyam. He said Shahru Quran. It means to renew our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama said, من أراد أن يكلم الله فليدخل في الصلاة ومن أراد أن يكلمه الله فليقرأ القرآن. He said, if you want to talk to Allah, get into the prayers. But if you want Allah to talk to you, read the Quran. Every time you recite, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe. He said, if the ocean were the ink to write with the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the meaning of these verses of the Quran, it says that you will, you know, finish the ink and the word of Allah will never finish. Even if you bring, as another ayah, he said, seven times of that ocean, and the depends as the count of the trees on the world, you cannot finish the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, this is the miracle of the world. In a time that people are ignorant about the Quran, people are attacking Islam and the Quran, but Allah is telling us, it doesn't matter what is happening outside, keep connected with the Quran. It doesn't matter what people talk about the Quran, what people say about Islam, what people say about Muslims, know that this is hudan linnas, and we will recite these verses till the day of judgment. It is a guidance to humanity. And Allah did not say guidance to those who believe. Remember, in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, He said, Alif Lam Mim, Dhalika Al-Kitab. That's the book, La Rayba Fih, no doubt in it, hudan lil-muttaqin. He said, guidance for those who are muttaqin, those who are righteous, those who are seeking guidance. But here, when he said, Shahru Ramadan, he said, hudan lil-nas. Because in the ultimate thing about the Quran is it is guidance for everyone. A young boy who is 5 years old from Bosnia is memorizing the whole Quran. A child from Africa who is 7 years old memorizing the Quran. A young girl from Malaysia or Indonesia memorizing the Quran. This is the miracle of the Quran. These words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put on the mouth of those young children to tell the world, this is my miracle on the earth. And this is the message, brothers and sisters. We're going to expand. 30, 40 years ago, this community did not exist. And today you see the numbers, you see the expansion. And that's exactly what we are doing here today. I'm here today to call upon all of you to make a difference and be the best of the person. Because when you read the Quran, every time Allah talks about the salah, talks giving, every time to build yourself from within, you have to build the society within you. You have to build the community at large. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. From what we sustain them, they are actually spent for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, knowledge is not enough. And being knowledgeable is not enough. You have to act. And every one of us, even if you are knowledgeable or not, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before becoming a prophet, before becoming a messenger, he was already in the work to help the community. إِنَّكَ لَتَصِلُ الرَّحِمُ وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلْبُ وَتَكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومُ وَتُعِيمُ عَلَى الْوَالِدِ الْحَقِّ. This is the shahada. This is the witness of his wife, Khadija radiallahu anha, told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that this is who you are. For 15 years I've been married to you, and now you have the message that you already are in the service of the community. And that's exactly what we are doing today. We need to build the new masjid, inshallah. This is a gymnasium. This is a multi-purpose hall. But it is used right now as a masjid. We need to build the masjid, brothers and sisters. And tonight, inshallah, we are trying to give our sadaqah. We are trying to give our money. We are trying to give what Allah has trusted us with to build the new masjid, inshallah. So after Jummah, I ask all of you to sit for a few minutes, inshallah, and challenge yourself. I know that every one of us, wallahi, if every one of us tonight give $1,000 as a seed money, we will have the masjid built the next 6 months, inshallah. I know that for sure, because I have seen it with my own eyes. Wallahi, our community built the masjid. Now they are building it within 6 months. You know why? Because every person felt that I am in charge of this community. I am in charge of this deen. I am in charge of the Quran. I am in charge of this Islam and no one else. And I want to be the pioneer, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, As-sabiqoon, as-sabiqoon, ulaika al-muqarrabun. Those who are the pioneers, those who have come forward and made a difference in the life of humanity. Don't turn your back in the month of Ramadan for an opportunity that might enter you and me to Jannah. Don't turn your back for something beautiful that you will see the moment after so many years, and you will turn around and you say, Subhanallah, I have my money in this beautiful building of Allah. And remember Hadith Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Man bana lillahi baytan, bana lahu Allah baytan fil Jannah. When you build the house of Allah, Allah will guarantee you a house in Jannah. One of the ulama said, if you think that Allah will build you a house in Jannah, He will take you to hellfire. If you have a house reserved in Jannah, you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you astray, Allah will keep you on the right path. So brothers and sisters, give inshallah a few minutes after the salah, so we can inshallah help one another to build Baytullah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as we can. And we'd like to invite you tonight for the iftar, inshallah, to come here and be with the family, all of you. I know some of you maybe don't live here, but brothers and sisters, this is the beauty of the Quran. This is the beauty of Islam. When he said, Hudan linnas, not only for, you know, for certain people or certain ethnicity, he said, for all humanity, that's all we need to make a difference. Allahumma aghfir lana warhamna wa'afina wa'fu 'anna wa taqabbal minna innaka antas samiu al-'alim wa tub 'alayna ya mawlana innaka antat tawwab ar-rahim. Allahumma la tuj'alna fi maqamina hadha dhanban illa ghafarta wa la daynan illa qadayta wa la maridan illa shafaita wa la mayitan illa rahimta wa la dhalan illa hadayta wa la 'asiran illa yassarta wa la asiran illa fakadta asra wa la mazluman illa nasarta wa la ghaliman illa ahlakta wa la hajjan ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها لنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا